ladies and gentlemen. My name is Marco Gore, and that is 747 home cockpit, full-size cockpit.
So welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Marco Governali, 747 home cockpit. So what we're going to do today, this is just for fun, of course. We are going to fly from Dubai to Mumbai. And of course, it's going to be a very nice summer flight. No problem at all, except that about 10 minutes before landing in Mumbai, India, we are going to simulate two engine failure, double engine failure on the left side. So engine number one and two are going to fail, bird strike, whatever. And it's going to be interesting because we're only going to have power on the right side. And we're going to try and land in Mumbai with just power on the right side. It should be interesting. Not sure what's going to happen, but we'll see, okay? So let's give it a go. Thank you.
You should become fully seated with your chair back straight and tray table stowed.
Signore e signori, siete pregati di fare attenzione ai monitor collocati in cabina per ricevere alcune informazioni importanti sulle caratteristiche di sicurezza e le procedure da seguire a bordo dell'aeromobile. Siete pregati di verificare di aver allacciato correttamente le cinture di sicurezza, di aver alzato lo schienale del sedile e di aver posto il vassoio davanti a voi in posizione chiusa.
Chiudete i tavolini e posizionate lo schienale della poltrona verticalmente prima del decollo e dell'atterraggio. Fasten your seatbelt and adjust it around your hips.
Veuillez boucler votre ceinture de sécurité et l'ajuster sur vos hanches.
To release the belt, just click the button.
Pour la détacher, il suffit de soulever la bouche. Nous vous demandons de toujours garder votre ceinture attachée lorsque vous êtes assis. Si vous n'êtes pas à votre place quand la consigne des ceintures s'allume, une annonce vous demandera de retourner et d'attacher votre ceinture.
We require the use of your seatbelt at all times while you are seated. Should you be away from your seat, when the seatbelt sign lights up, an announcement prompting you to return to your seat and fasten your seatbelt will be made. Air Canada is pleased to provide a non-smoking environment.
Air Canada a le plaisir de vous offrir un environnement sans fumée à bord de tous ses avions.
Okay, hold on a minute. Vous
ne devez pas utiliser de téléphone cellulaire à bord à cause des interférences avec les fréquences avions.
Some of your telephones must not be used due to interference with aircraft frequencies. Laptop computers may only be used while the seatbelt sign is turned on. At no time may outboard directive devices such as printers be used. Please check with a crew member before using any other electronic device.
L'emploi d'un ordinateur portatif est permis pendant que la consigne des ceintures est éteinte. En aucun cas, les périphériques externes comme des imprimantes ne doivent être utilisés. Avant de vous servir d'un autre appareil électronique, veuillez vérifier auprès d'un membre d'équipage. S'il fallait évacuer l'avion, un éclairage sur le côté du siège vous guiderait vers l'issue de secours la plus proche.
If there is a need to evacuate, a It should be reviewed prior to takeoff.
Number one, valve open. And two, rotation.
During the flight, if the cabin pressure changes, an oxygen mask will drop automatically from the panel above.
And two, 20%.
Seat.
Fuel lever on
high. Use the support strap of one mask over your mouth.
36%.
Adjust your mask.
Valve closed.
Breathe normally.
Start number three, valve open.
Always secure your mouth mask before assisting the other person.
Si la pression de la cabine change en cours de vol, le masque à oxygène tombera automatiquement vers le panneau au-dessus. Restez assis. Tirez le masque de vol. Servez-vous de la montre d'oxygène pour appuyer sur votre nez au
milieu.
Ajustez votre masque. Respirez normalement.
Mettez
toujours votre masque en premier avant d'éviter le micro.
In caso di depressurizzazione, le maschere per l'ossigeno si renderanno automaticamente disponibili. Prendete una maschera e attivatela tirandola verso di voi. Coprite il naso e bocca, regolatela e respirate normalmente. Indossate prima la vostra maschera e poi aiutate chi necessita.
necessita della vostra assistenza. Questa è la maschera di ossigeno. Funziona regolarmente, anche se il sacchetto di plastica non si gonfia. Tutte le uscite di emergenza di questo aereo sono indicate da appositi segnali individuali. Il sentiero inondato faciliterà il raggiungimento di uscite. In caso di rapido apertura dell'aereo, lasciate a bordo il bagaglio a mano, togliete le scarpe con i tacchi alti.
Dans la situation confortable que le prend sur Monsieur Young, prenez le gilet sauvetage qui se trouve sous votre fauteuil ou votre appuyoir. Retirez-le de sa pochette.
In the unlikely event of an emergency over water, remove the life vest from the pouch under your seat or below your armrest. Place the life vest over your head, fasten the waist clips, and tighten the belt. Pulling the tabs will inflate the life vest. If it does not inflate immediately, it can be inflated by blowing into the tubes. The life vest should only be inflated as you leave the aircraft.
Passez la tête dans l'encolure, fixez les crochets autour de la taille et tirez sur les courroies. Pour gonfler le gilet, tirez sur les lambettes. S'il ne se gonfle pas immédiatement, soufflez dans les tubes. Ne gonflez votre gilet qu'au moment de quitter l'avion. Nous vous remercions d'avoir choisi Air Canada. Nous espérons que ce vol vous plaira.
Thank you for choosing Air Canada. We hope you enjoy the flight.
Left is clear, right is clear, open the start engines.
Start number two, valve open.
And two rotations. Number rotation. Two, sorry buddy.
Oil pressure.
You are clear for taxi, please wait for the
taxi. Two, turn left hand side. Got it. Fuel lever, come over. Fuel flow, 5.2, 46%. Valve closed.
So we're good to go. Good.
Standard 2992. 1000.
delle partite regali utilizzando il pagamento denaro contante a segno con il credito. Non esitate a rivolgervi al vostro equipaggio per qualunque vostra necessità, affinché il vostro viaggio possa essere il più gradevole possibile. Ladies and gentlemen, the flight attendants will shortly be making their way through the cabin to offer various beverages of your choice. There will also be a selection of goods available for purchase, and we can accept most credit cards, checks, and cash. If there is anything we can do to make your trip more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask. And we would like you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the flight.
Feet now, so we're gonna post the video because from now on it's gonna be fairly boring, and we're gonna turn it back on about 15 minutes before we land, and we're gonna have a double engine failure both on the left side, so it's gonna be a pretty interesting landing. Okay, so I'll see you guys soon. So welcome back. We are about 12 minutes, about 105 miles, nautical miles, out of Mumbai, India. So we are starting a descent, and as I said before, we are going to experience a double engine failure on the same side about 10 minutes or 8 to 10 minutes from landing, and we'll see what happens.
1,000 to go.
Okay, so we are going to shut down two engines on the left side. Of course, we are simulating two engines going out, bird strike, whatever you like. And we'll see what happens. So shutting down engine number one. Number two. Of this altitude is not a problem yet because we have enough speed and two engines is more than enough for now anyways. The autopilot compensates for it. The interesting part is going to come when switch to manual, we'll see what happens. Of course, the two engines on the right side are working extra hard right now to compensate for the other side, and the airplane is flying like this. It's banging to the left, of course. What's happening right now, the two engines on the right side are pushing more, of course, than they should. So the airplane is getting pushed this way. Then the rudder is... So if the rudder stays straight, the airplane would automatically go left. So the rudder has to, of course, to go right in order to compensate. So surfaces are working against each other. And as a matter of fact, even though the autopilot is supposed to keep me on the pink line, of my flight plan, even though the rudder is pushing me right, the airplane is actually
having a hard time staying on the line, and it's actually to the left of the line. Hopefully we can land soon. From the airport. Hopefully we can get a hold of them and we go.
Ogni medaglia a mano deve trovarsi sotto il sedile di fronte al vostro o nell'armadietto in alto. Gli assistenti di volo procederanno ad un controllo finale della cabina raccogliendo eventuali tazze o bicchieri. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask that you store any electronic devices until we are safety parts at the gate, as use of such devices can interfere with electronic landing equipment on board
vehicle.
In final preparation for landing, please ensure your seat belts are securely fastened, your seat bags are in the upright position, and that your tray tables are stored. Any hand luggage should be underneath the seat in front of you or placed in the overhead locker. The flight attendants will be passing through the cabin one last time to complete the final compliance check and to collect any remaining cups or glasses.
Transition altitude. Altimeters. 2992. Go.
runways are 8 o'clock. So we're going to turn nice and wide. And what we're going to do is, since we've got power on the right side, no power on the left side, we are going to stay to the right of the runway, slightly right of the runway, because if we stay left, the moment I need thrust, the airplane is going to automatically take it off the runway. So we're going to stay, if this is the runway, we're going to stay right here until we line up, and then we're going to land, hopefully. That's the plan anyways.
Localizer alive.
Good stuff. Okay, so we're gonna switch to manual. Hope for the best.
Localizer captured.
Got
her. Set this approach, please. Okay, I got set. Speed check. Spoilers up.
Bank angle.
Got it.
Bank angle. Bank angle.
Speed check.
Way, way too high. Doesn't look very good at all. You're gonna have to go around. One more time, of course. can't stay up in the sky. We're just too high, just we're not good at all, so might as well take a chance, especially when we only got two engines. So what I did there, of course you might agree or you might not agree, I tried to land without using as little thrust as possible, meaning let the airplane just float on the runway
And of course, in order to achieve that, I had to land a little bit faster than usual, a little bit higher than usual. Why? Because if you land at the normal speed, 160 to 170, and you lose it, if you stall it, the airplane is gonna just hit the ground like a brick. So I landed a little bit faster, a little bit higher, so that I didn't have to use the thrust. Because if you use the thrust at the end, in the end, when you're landing, you only get power on the right side, and the airplane is automatically go like this, and you're finished, basically. You're gonna land on the grass. So I used the thrust until the airplane was lined up with the runway, but then I landed basically like a glider, so that when the thrust is off, the airplane doesn't care whether the engines are working or not. It's just floating onto the ground, gliding onto the runway. So that's what I tried to do, you know. And thank God it worked, okay? So of course, different opinions. I understand we all have different opinions, but that's what I would have done if I were in command of a 747 with only two engines in real life. And it worked on my simulator, so in theory it should work. Oh, so make comments, let me know what you think, and let me know what you would have done, and ask for whatever video you want, whatever airports, whatever situation, just whatever emergency, and we'll try and duplicate it, okay? Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you soon.